Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and guests. Welcome to Division N's Evaluation Marathon. I am Toastmaster Anjali, the Sergeant at Arms for today's session. Let me begin today's session by stating our district's mission. We build new clubs and support all clubs in achieving excellence. At Toastmasters, we refrain from talking about sex, politics, and religion in derogatory manner in our speeches. Some rules to be respected during the meeting. Maintain the decorum of the virtual meeting room by muting and letting video on. In case you need to move, please do so by turning your video off so to avoid the speaker getting disturbed during a speech. So everyone, please turn on their videos. Muting and unmuting of speakers will be handled by the Zoom master. So wait for your turn to speak and follow the general meeting flow. Do not share your screen unless asked by the Zoom master. The gestures such as thumbs up, clap, and hands up are available in the reaction option. Please make use of the gestures. Please do not explore other features during the meeting room to avoid hindrance. Please help me welcome the moderator for today, Toastmaster Anubhuti.
Thank you, Toastmaster Anjali. Look at our bodies. It performs so many functions. Hands have different functions to perform, legs have different, ears have different, and similarly the eyes. They look at things in their own ways, having their keen observation towards understanding the mistakes, looking at the good and appreciating it. And this loop of observation continues until we reach a satisfactory goal. Similar is the role of an evaluator, like a keen eye. When he evaluates a speech, he observes things, provides constructive feedback, appreciates the good things, and also suggests the do's and don'ts needed. As all the clubs are heading towards the club contest, this evaluation marathon will help the participants and the attendees to enhance and work on their evaluation skills and ease in their evaluation contest. And for this, we are not alone today. Each day we will have a super evaluator who will evaluate our participant evaluators and also let them know what they did well and also the areas of improvement. A very good evening to all the Toastmasters, district officers and their guests. I am Toastmaster Anubhuti Kakkar, member of Gurukul.Education Toastmaster Club and the moderator for today's meeting. For the benefit of our participants and super evaluator, I would like to tell you all the flow and rules for the marathon. There will be a test speaker who will present their speech. Evaluators can make notes during that time. Once the speech is done, Zoom Master will send all the evaluators along with Sergeant at Arms and Timer 2 to a breakout room where they'll get 5 minutes to complete their evaluation. While in the breakout room, contestant will keep the microphone and camera turned on, hands in the range of the camera, and not use any electronic devices. Once 5 minutes are over, timer shall indicate to stop writing immediately. The first contestant shall be moved to the main room with the timer. The remaining contestants shall be moved to the main room with the timer. The remaining contestants shall keep their video and audio throughout their presence in their breakout room. Their hands shall be visible at all times. After each evaluator, we will observe 1 minute of silence for the super evaluator to mark their feedback. After the last evaluator, we will observe 3 minutes of silence for the super evaluator to complete their evaluation. Then we will invite our super evaluator to present their feedback, and after that, we will proceed to the certificate presentation. So, as I mentioned above, today we have Toastmaster Beena Madrikar as our super evaluator. She has been a Toastmaster for over a decade and has taken leadership roles as a director, division director, and other district level roles such as district judge, district newsletter editor. She has taken part in all 4 contests and reached division and district level several times. This year, she podium finished the evaluation contest district level. Toastmaster has been an integral part of her life, and she has mentored many Toastmasters in her club as well as the beyond the club. We welcome you, ma'am, to the Division N Evaluation Marathon. So, Let us start our day, first day, and let me call upon the test speaker for today, Toastmaster Sakshi Bhuval. Zoom Master, can you please spotlight Sakshi?
Hi Anubhuti, am I audible?
Yes, you are audible. Yes, you are audible as well as visible. Are we good to go? Can you see the timer cards?
Just wait. No, I cannot see the timer cards. Yes, I can see the timer cards.
Okay.
Can you?
Yes. Are we good to go now?
Yes, we are good to go.
Toastmaster Sakshi, gratitude. Gratitude, Toastmaster Sakshi.
Thank you, Madam Toastmaster Anubhuti. Do you remember how our teachers used to give us a chocolate on submitting assignments timely? And on being disciplined, we used to be rewarded by being the star of the week. My dentist used to give me a toffee each time I used to go for a general checkup. All the people who have appreciated my teeniest effort to do something positive in life have created a positive push towards a healthy lifestyle, and I would like to thank all of them. Fellow Toastmasters and dear guests, yes, the topic for the day is gratitude. Gratitude in simple words is the quality of being thankful, readiness to show appreciation and to return kindness. It has always been hard for me to show gratitude, not because I am short of words or I am shy, but I never realized the importance of this noble gesture. As a person, I am quite notorious, and it takes a lot of efforts from my end to sit at one place and concentrate. I can hardly sit for 15 minutes in one place and study. While I was preparing for my 10th board examination back in 2016, I used to study for 15 minutes, then look left or look right and start chatting with anyone sitting next to me. So one fine day, my tutor made me sit next to Aditi. Aditi was this Miss Know-It-All, and each time I used to look at her to talk, she used to yell at me and make me study. Her constant yelling actually made me sit there for hours and study. Eventually, I scored beyond expectations, but it did not even occur to me once to thank her, and we lost contact in junior college. Time flew by, but my 15-year-old brain was still intact in my 19-year-old body until last December. Last December, my family suffered from the waves of COVID-19. The wave took away my grandpa. I'd already lost my paternal grandfather at the age of 3. So now the only source of grandfather's love was my Nanu. I spent my entire 4 years of high school with my Nanu and my Nani while my parents were away for my father's cancer treatment. I remember throwing tantrums at my granny about how boring the dinner is, and then my granddad used to scold me for throwing tantrums at her, and then he used to drift the topic by scolding me more about my late night habits. But it was always so beautiful with them. We boarded our first flight together. I was 17, he was 70, but that is one memory that I'll ever cherish. While he used to restrict me for eating outside, he himself used to crave for Bombay chapati, and then we used to crash on Juhu eating vada pav and gola. 4-5 days after he passed away, I was lying down on my bed. Tears had blurred my vision. My heart was heavy, and each time I used to close my eyes, I could see him standing just next to me. That night, I realized I never told him how much I loved him or how important he was to me. I never mentioned it to him that how he has been the coolest man that I've ever met, and how his small gestures like massaging my legs while waking me up and then serving me and my granny Betty were one of the softest gestures that I had ever known. I had ample of opportunities to show my love, but lack of awareness has put me into guilt that I had a man so noble, but I could not appreciate him for what he was. That night I was trying to put my feelings into a word. Was it love? No, he knew I loved him. It can't be love. I kept on thinking for days, until I realized it to be gratitude. Only if I could get this one chance to tell him how grateful I am for everything he has done for me and my family. But now, as I've lost it, I don't miss a single opportunity to show how grateful I am for certain things and certain people in life. Last February, when I met Aditi in my school reunion, I just went to her and I hugged her. After losing touch for so long, even she did not see that coming. But when I just parted from her, I just told how grateful I was for her scolding me like that each day that I studied so hard and I scored so nice. A simple smile broke on her face, and that was the time I understood the beauty of gratitude. Being grateful is not an obligation or something you should do, but something you should do for a practice to make, or it's not a practice to maintain a healthy relationship, but it's an act of love. I know it sounds very cheesy when I say it, but just give it a thought. Telling someone that how much you are moved by someone's effort is a sheer act of selflessness. And love is nothing but a sheer act of selflessness. All of these incidents of my life have made me think, if I've ever been thankful in life, the answer is yes. But have I been expressing my gratitude? The answer is no. Feeling grateful and not expressing it is a waste of expression. It's like packing a present and then not presenting it. Therefore, now I would like to ask all of you to close your eyes and ask yourself, if you have been grateful for everything you have in your life. Back to you, Toastmaster Anu. Thank you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Sakshi, for such a beautiful speech and making us all realize the value of gratitude in our lives. So moving forward, now I request the Zoom master to send all the evaluators along with T Timer 2 and S Padded at Arms to the breakout room. Please confirm once done.
To all the evaluators, Sergeant Arms and Timer 2, the breakout room is open. Request everyone to join in. Timer 2, Toastmaster Bhavini, please join the breakout room. Moderator, all the participants are in the breakout room. We can proceed.
Thank you, Zoom Master. Now I request the timer to start the timing for 5 minutes. And please notify me once the 5 minutes are up. Thank you. By the time, I request our Toastmaster Sakshi to come on the stage for a quick Q&A session and certificate presentation. Zoom Master, can you please? Yeah, thank you. So Toastmaster Sakshi, I came to know that you are also in the field of doodling. So can you please share your experience with us all?
Thank you, Anubhuti. So with my experience with doodling is quite personal. As I did not start it in a very professional note. I started it because I was actually bored and upset. And that's how I started drawing in the back of my notebooks with a black pen, because black pen is my favorite pen. So that's how it started. And then while I was 18, just about to join college, I realized I want to do this. I want to make more art. And that's how it began, and it never stopped for me. So that's my journey with doodling. I hope to make more new arts in the
But black pen is my favorite too. Now, can you also tell me your best and the funniest moment in Toastmaster up till now?
Yeah, sure. Give me a minute. Yeah.
Yeah, sure.
So my moment up till now in Toastmasters is the time I got the most strict evaluation, because that day somebody actually pulled me down from cloud nine and showed me the right path to go on. When it comes to in the field of speech craft, and I'm quite serious when it comes to speech craft. So that was the best day when I got a very nice mentor who helped me to, who actually pointed my mistakes and made me go through the journey. And the funny part was that there was this one club contest that I was a test speaker at, and my mother wanted to collect my laundry. So I was in the middle of my speech, 4 minutes, 30 seconds, just about to qualify, when my mama interrupted, and she was speaking in the local tongue about how she wants me to take my laundry and I should open the door. And then my sister also started banging the door, and I was so embarrassed that I forgot my whole speech. So that was a very funny incident, that embarrassing incident that I have in Toastmasters.
Okay, thank you, Toastmaster Sakshi, for your wonderful answers. So here is your certificate of appreciation. Congratulations, Toastmaster Sakshi.
Thank you, Anubhuti.
Welcome. Now I request the timer to notify me once the 5 minutes are over. As the 5 minutes are over, now I request Zoom Master to send evaluator one, that is Toastmaster Hargun, to the main meeting room. Can we have a quick audio and video check, Toastmaster Hargun?
Good evening, moderator Anubhuti. Am I clearly audible and visible this evening?
Yes, you are clearly audible and visible. Can you see the timer cards?
Yes, they are visible to me.
Okay, are we good to go?
Yes.
Evaluator number one, Toastmaster Hargun. Toastmaster Hargun.
Gratitude. What a wonderful speech, Toastmaster Sakshi. You know, the energy with which you began the speech, it was amazing. Although if you could understand the speech, it was not that intense in the moment in a very positive way, because the incidences were one of those things that made me realize that yes, there are some rough moments of life where we need to understand that life is very much better, very much exotic when we do not have such ups and downs. But that's what is life. Your speech began with the question that actually, what is gratitude? And you explained the meaning, which was very wonderful over here, because people often confuse gratitude with thanksgiving to any situation or thing that they do. One of the most exotic and applicable things that I really felt with this speech of yours. You began the speech, it was evidently great, because people generally, apologies. Your speech was filled with personal experiences that made people feel connected amongst themselves. And obviously with the speaker, your voice modulation, your understanding of the flow of the speech and the incidences which you were saying. There was one thing that really, really struck me. It was that your modulation with the words anxiety, with the words sadness and happiness were one of those things where ample stress was given to make sure that the people feel connected with the story at relevant times. Coming to the recommendations of some commendations, the first very visible recommendation is that the lighting was not proper. I feel there might be some network connectivity issue or an electricity cut down due to which you were not clearly visible. The structure of the speech was something that confused me in the start, because you took your friend Aditi's reference in the start and in the end with some abrupt personal experiences. And I really did not feel that the two ends at the start and at the end were connected in a way. So I feel you could have done just a bit more justice over there. The eye contact with the audience. I can understand in an online platform, it is tough to maintain an eye contact with the web camera, but I really feel that this is at this point, you could just give a slight focus on focusing more on the camera at the center of the camera where you feel more connected, because it was seeming like you were giving an experience, but the audience was like Sakshi is talking to herself and she's narrating something more than giving a speech. The last recommendation I would like to give is the transitions to me were not that clear. Overall, if I come to the commendations again, I really loved your speech with the connection, with the flow, with your personal experiences, with your Nanu, with Aditi. I'm sure Aditi would have loved if she would have been over here. And the constant energy with which you were driving people, it made people want to listen to you more and more. So with this, over to the moderator. Thank you very much. It was a wonderful speech and it was a pleasure to hear you this evening.
Thank you, Toastmaster Hargun. Now we will observe 1 minute of silence for our super evaluator to mark her feedback. Hello, Toastmaster Aditi. Can we have a quick audio and video check?
Am I audible and visible?
Yes, you're audible and you're visible. Can you see the timer cards?
No, I cannot see the timer cards. 1 second. Yeah, now they're visible.
Okay, are we good to go?
Yeah, sure.
Evaluator 2, Toastmaster Aditi, Toastmaster Aditi.
Okay, so first of all, congratulations on giving such a wonderful speech. So the title of the speech was Gratitude, and I think that the speaker totally justified the topic because she started it with her life story. So at the beginning, she told about how her friend helped her and at scoring well in her school. So I think that starting with a story helps the evaluators and all the audience to get engrossed in the speech. Then I think that the speech was completely engaging and impactful. Also, the flow of speech was great, talking about your life and how being grateful to others can make their day. Her audio was clear, she was completely audible. Her energy level was completely balanced. She had a total eye contact she was engaging with the audience. Then her body language was good. And I think that the star of the speech was using this line that love is sheer act of selflessness. And yes, I think that it is true. And she's trying to give us a lesson. Now coming to the recommendations. First thing, she used this line, feeling grateful and not expressing it is something that is not justified. And just like that, she was not giving her speech in a standing position. I know that she was facing some issue, but still she could have managed. And somehow if she was standing, so I could have seen her hand gestures in a better way and how she was using her body language. Then the second thing is, she had the same flow of speech in her she had the same flow of voice modulation. So I believe that she could have used different voice modulations at different times. And the third thing I think is that she used a very wise topic, that is gratitude, but she could have added something more and made it a more challenging speech. So I think that other than this, this was a commendable speech, and kudos to that. So thank you, and over to the moderator.
Thank you, Toastmaster Aditi. Now we'll have 1 minute of silence for the super evaluator to mark her feedback. So, Master, can we have Toastmaster Shweta in the spotlight? Okay, Toastmaster Shweta, can we have a quick audio and video check?
Yes, I'm clearly audible and visible.
Yes, you are. Can you see the timer cards?
Yes.
Are we good to go?
Yes.
Okay. Evaluator number 3, Toastmaster Shweta. Toastmaster Shweta.
Good evening, my fellow Toastmasters and everyone. And special good evening to my speaker, that is Sakshi. So the way she started, do you remember how ma'am used to give chocolates? It grabbed the audience. It has grabbed the audience. Like, do you remember when she speaks? Then she come to the way that thank you for all of them. That made her speech more enlightening. It gripped the audience a lot. It attracted with the audience. The speech quality was a mixture of so many emotions that everyone has felt somewhere in their life. The way she started with her friend, then two grandpas, and the way she declared all her emotions with her grandpa and the gratitude she wants to show. then all things were mixed with her real life experience, and that was a commendable job. Even the gestures were good. Then she said that I was lying down in a bed and my heart was heavy. That was also too amazing that we all can connect with her in somehow. She were very much amazing with her voice, and the confidence she was wearing and the smile she was keeping was too good. Her story was having so much personal touch, which were relatable. I thoroughly enjoyed her speech a lot. Now, I would like to tell my structure, that's how I want to give the evaluation. That is her structure, delivery, and content. The structure was well organizing. The opening was well good, that it attracted the audience a lot. Introduction was also short and precise, which enhanced the audience. Body and conclusion, which somewhere she was missing with that. Delivery, her voice modulations was good. She was getting a good confidence. The eye contact and enthusiasm. She was too much energetic that we all can see that even she was facing the power cut, then also she come up and speak with confidence. Her content and story was realistic and amazing. Now, some recommendations that I would like to give is, if she can work on her voice modulation and the sound like this, that was repeatedly, and the eye contact was somewhere missing. And she said that she wants 30 seconds at last to show. If she could ask the timer and tell that yes, these 30 seconds is there, so it can attract the audience a more. So coming to my overall summary, she was very good in organizing. It was having a well-structured story. There are very few people who can be so energetic in online platform, and she was blessed with this. I thoroughly enjoyed her speech. I challenge her to work on her voice modulation. Thank you.
Thank you, Toastmasters, Shweta. Now we will observe 3 minutes of silence for our super evaluator to compile her feedback. And by the time super evaluator compiles her feedback, let's have the certificate presentation for our participants. Congratulations, Toastmaster Hargun, for participating in the marathon.
Thanks a lot for this opportunity.
Congratulations, Aditi, for participating.
Thank you so much.
Congratulations, Shweta.
Thank you.
Timer, please confirm once the 3 minutes are over. Now the 3 minutes are over, and now I request our super evaluator, DTM Beena Madrekar, to share her feedback for the evaluators.
Thank you very much. I'm so happy to be here amongst all of you, and I've heard three brilliant evaluators give their evaluation for our Toastmasters test speech. Now, I've got 18 to 20 minutes to wrap up this whole thing. So, first of all, I would like to tell you that this is with a view towards the evaluation contest, right? Now, if you look at the evaluation contest judges ballot, which I think all of you participants who are going to participate in your club contest and eventually go on to area and to division and district, have to look at the 1179 evaluation judges ballot evaluation contest. It starts with 1179. You'll find it online or you'll find it in the website, our District 98 website. Download it, keep it beside your bed and study it like a Bible. Because the judges are going to evaluate you. Yes, Yash has done it and sent it to everyone. Thank you very much. So, Yash, if it's possible and if it can be shared as I'm talking, I would love to, in the first 5 minutes to... Yes, thank you very much. Such a good host you are. Okay, here we have analytical quality has 40 marks. Okay, now... As I'm talking, each of the evaluators, please check what I'm saying. I'm not going to pinpoint each and everything. But when you come here in front of the judges and the audience, you are giving a 2 to 3 minute speech on your own, a mini speech. And as we've been told, the opening of your speech should be brilliant. The body should contain 2 to 3 points and the end should be a conclusion or a summary of what you have said is what you should do. You cannot come here and say, okay, so, wow, well, good evening. That was nice. Okay, now I'm going to evaluate Sakshi. Will you do that when you're giving a speech? No, you are giving a speech here. Open brilliantly. Start with something like gratitude. The word is so commonplace. And yet our test speaker, Sakshi, converted it into a brilliant 5 to 7 minute speech. Okay, start, go straight for the kill. Don't dilly-dally and so, okay, now good evening. Don't do all that. That is number one, not to do. So those who, amongst the three evaluators, those who shrugged their shoulders and smiled and all at the camera, don't do that. Stand in front of the camera, nest for a while. They say you have to nest. Means you have to allow the audience to look at you while you are looking at the camera and not here and there and at the audience and at the gallery, at that little white light which is on your laptop, the camera. Right now I'm looking at the camera. If you can see me looking at you, that means I have succeeded in looking straight at the camera and therefore at you. So come here, stand, smile, or sit, smile. I don't have anything against someone sitting or someone standing. So remember who's someone commented on the test speaker sitting. Try and not use sitting or standing as a recommendation or even a commendation. Okay, that is commonplace. Don't use that. There are so many things to recommend, so many things to commend. So avoid using standing, sitting. Because this is an online speech, even the best of speakers at the world contest may have been sitting and speaking. How do you know? They've just put the camera in front of you like that and the face is there. What do you know if I'm sitting or standing? I'm just talking into the camera. The point was right. Someone said you were not looking at the camera. You were looking beside you. It was as if you were talking to yourself, which was a very pertinent point and a relevant point. We want the speaker to look at us. So that was a point. Sitting and standing, koi maine nahi rakhta, as they say in Hindi, is of very little consequence. Okay, so try and get that out of your commendation or recommendation. Now we're talking about analytical 40 marks. So analyze your speech, open brilliantly, gratitude is a word, etc., etc. Now, my test speaker, yours, let me analyze your speech. Use the word analysis. So the judges are very happy to say, okay, now 40 marks I have to give. She started analyzing the speech. How do you analyze a speech? By looking at her opening, by looking at her body, and looking at the conclusion. And mentioning what you liked. There are certain things you may not have liked. So mention what you liked in glowing terms. Please do not use the word amazing, wonderful, without giving any examples. Amazing, wonderful, out of your vocabulary. We don't have anything to say, so we say amazing. Don't do that. So analyze the speech means, how did she open the speech? Was the audience hooked? Yes, with her questions. What was the body containing? It had 2 to 3 points. One was her not offering gratitude to Aditi or thank you to Aditi. One was her missing her both her grandparents, and one was that brief reference to her parents who were away because of some cancer problem, and she was only solely dependent on her grandparents. So that particular personal story affected us as the audience. And her ending also was brilliant when she looped in Aditi again and brought her back into the story. Okay, that is your analysis of the story. This is what you liked, or this is what I liked, I will say. And remember, you have to say, I like. Don't talk for the audience on behalf of the audience. Say what I like. Now you come to recommendations. Now remember, my dear Yash and others who gave Hargun, not Yash, sorry for what I'm saying, Yash. Hargun gave 4 recommendations. Do not give 4. No. That poor speaker is so nervous. Oh my God, here come the recommendations. And you're giving 4. 30 marks for recommendation, no, give 3. Even if you have 15 in your recommendation list, give only 3 main ones. And that too, give 3, some search something from inside and give. Go deep into the speech and give the recommendation. Don't give upar upar ka recommendation. Your camera position was not good. The light was not good. We cannot control external factors in a Zoom meeting. We cannot. It's not professional. We are not in a studio. We are in our own home. Sometimes a doorbell rings. Like our test speaker said, my mother spoke to me in her language, etc., etc. It happens. My grandson is always knocking at my door when I'm closing it. I want to go here. Have you done this? And I'm happily talking on the phone, on the Zoom, but he has to be answered. These things happen, lights happen. We are not going to use that as a recommendation. Go deep into the content of the speech. Okay. So you have 3 recommendations. Now, technique, how do you give that recommendation? Don't say, but, however, you know, actually the recommendations are not like that. Then the speaker feels very upset and said, oh my God, here comes the recommendations. Use nice words, conjunctions, and you spoke brilliantly, you spoke wonderfully, especially the part where, okay, now there are certain things you liked in the top part, analytical part. Please give examples for everything that you liked and for every improvement required. Please give examples. Your voice modulation should have been good. Are where? Where? All over or only one part? Someone did say, I'll come to that, but where? Don't make general statements. Substantiate them with examples. Okay? These are few points you have to remember. You have to. Don't go all over the place saying wonderful, brilliant, and then get lost in your notes. Keep bullet points ready and keep it in your head. Okay? So recommendations 30, 15, technique. How you give it? Are you sympathetic, sensitive, and motivational? Will you motivate the speaker to come back again and to be a test speaker again? Yes, that is how the judges look at your evaluation, that you are motivating the speaker. So smile. All of you were smiling, which is good. But don't smile nervously. Smile because you are you and you are evaluating a test speaker and you are telling him, you are in love with the test speaker and you're telling him or her, wonderful, wonderful. I loved it. I really loved your speech. And I'll tell you why, especially those lines, etc. Now, and if you could have added a dialogue instead of narration, it would have been better. Where dialogue? where your grandfather told you, listen, let's not go anywhere. Let's go to Juhu Beach. And I agreed and I said, yes, grandpa, let's go. And both of us like children, he 70, I 17, we crash landed at Juhu Beach. Okay, that would have been a better scenario than just narration. Here's the example. Now, where are we? Technique. Okay, so that's the way you're smiling and telling, no feeling nervous and, oh God, I wish you had done this. Nothing. Just continue that same smile as you are giving the recommendation. And only three. Two, I'm thinking, but okay, you want 30 marks, you'll get 10, 10, 10, you know, straight away three. Clear cut ones, okay, with examples. And summary. Now, someone finished at green only. I don't know who I've written somewhere. Someone finished at green. Okay, thank you very much. My summary is this. Are you've got green, you've got yellow, you've got part of red. So much time. Don't finish early. Some people are running for time and you finished at green. In the summary, do not add anything new. Do not say, I forgot. I should have told her this. Okay, I'll put it in the summary. Do not. Summarize what you have told and you'll get 15 marks. What you told in the opening analytical speech, that you were good because of your opening, you were also good because of your voice modulation, you were good because of your eye contact, and your content was excellent because gratitude is a word that is often misunderstood and misused. So I like this. And if you had added a dialogue instead of narration, and if you had added as a recommendation, I'm telling you that if you had done this in especially here, you would have given a top-notch speech. As it is, your speech was good. Okay, this is your second part, recommendation, commendation, recommendation. This is a summary, and in the end, give a positive note and send her packing. Say, but your message came through clearly, Aditi, and I spent the best. Aditi Nesakshi, and I spent the best 5 to 7 minutes of my life listening to your speech. Thank you very much. Over to you, contest chair. Everything has to be clear cut, no nervousness, and it has to be to the point. And in your head, you have to have the bifurcations. Analytical means all the good points. Okay, having done that, whatever good you have mentioned in the analytical, don't mention that as a recommendation. You had a wonderful flow in your speech and your transitions were not good. If you're saying the flow was good, how can the transitions not be good? The transitions also have to be good. So don't negate what you have said as a commendation. Don't give as a recommendation. Okay, remember that. Keep separate. Commendation, three good things you like, 3 to 4. And outweigh the commendation to the recommendation. 4 commendations and 3 recommendations. 3 commendations, 2 recommendations. And summary, 3 plus 2 and a positive note at the end. That your message came through clear. That, okay, all that. Now 12 minutes are up. Now, let me go to each one. Then we can have a little bit of question answer if we have time. Okay, Hargun. Your commendation was, your energy was amazing. Thank you. Thank you for removing the sharing. Energy, amazing. I want another word. Why was the energy amazing? Immediately tell that you spoke with so much of vigor, especially the line when you said, gratitude is something that the teacher gives you as a sweet, or gratitude, whatever. I mean, whatever you thought, wherever you thought that energy was amazing, give that example. Okay, Hargun. Then you talked about how she said life has its ups and downs. Your definition of gratitude I liked. Okay, that was good. Voice was good, especially some words. Okay, you did say some words. You had a good flow, you said. Okay. Then your recommendations were 4. Improper lighting. Poor thing has got no lights at home. Has got minimum. I mean, she's fighting against all odds. So forget that lighting and I'll throw it out of the window. Okay. Structure confused me. Okay. Now, Aditi at the start and end. Okay, that's what confused you. I get it. That you gave Aditi in the beginning and you gave us Aditi in the end. So I did not understand that structure. So that confused me. Okay, but okay, you gave an example. That is your this thing. Okay, your eye contact was inadequate. You said you were the one who said no, that you were looking as if you were looking at yourself, which was a good point. I think even I thought she was looking at the side like that, and she was not looking at the camera. She was looking at the side. Maybe the script was beside her. I don't know. Transitions were not good. Now you just left this one line. Transitions were not good. Example. Where? Which transition? I don't know. The judge doesn't know. So he may not give you that recommendation mark, that out of 30, he may say, what do you mean transitions were not good? Which transition? You're not telling. Sorry, we are minusing 10 out of 30. Okay. Summary. In the summary, you said, Hargun, much more was said in the summary about commendation. See, when you opened, no, you gave a sketchy commendation. Energy was amazing. Talked about life up and downs. Definition of gratitude was good. Your voice was good, especially some words. That's all. Good flow. That's all you said. But in the summary, you said too much. Extra, you said. I don't want extra in the summary. I only want what you said. The judges will get confused if you give them extra. Okay? And no mention about recommendations at all in the summary. You did not mention recommendations. You only in the summary said, lovely, lovely, especially this. And I like the way you did this. And congratulations. Okay. So, one sec. There's someone calling. I will call later. 1 minute. Huh? Okay. So remember, in a summary, it has to have commendation, recommendation, and summary at the end. Has to have one positive line. Thank you very much. You've done an excellent job of giving us your vision of gratitude. I will take this home with me or something like that. Okay, that's Hargun. Now, Aditi. Aditi came with saying, okay. So first of all, Aditi, you're smiling and you're like a vulture, you know, in animal kingdom or whatever that. So what should we do now? I don't, Bagheera and all that little fellow. I don't know. What should we do now? It's like that. You're coming, shrugging your shoulders. You have to be very formal. You have to either wish contest chair, fellow Toastmasters and guests. That's all. I open sometimes like that. Otherwise, I open with a brilliant line, like a quote. I would have said, for instance, something I wrote down about her speech. I said, gratitude is a very precious emotion. And as the test speaker has said, it is a selfless emotion. Contest chair, fellow Toastmasters, and dear guests. And of course, my test speaker, Aditi. You have given us 5 to 7 minutes of your personal experience. And it was indeed a wonderful speech. Now, let me analyze it for you. Okay, open like that. Okay, don't say, okay, now, hello, etc. Now, gratitude justified the title, which is good. Green, 18 minutes. Okay, I got 2 minutes left. Starting with a story helps, engaging and impactful, audible, energy balance, eye contact, good. Some examples could have done there, some examples, okay? Especially, I like the line, love is an act of selflessness. That's a good point, okay? But there was no analysis. There was no analysis. You just give one line, one-liners. Recommendation, not standing, so we could not see the body language. Monotonous voice, topic, gratitude could have been more in-depth. Where, how, don't make fleeting statements, okay? Okay, give particular instance, for instance, for example. And overall good speech, and you finished at green. You are the one who finished at green. You should have done much more in terms of analysis of the speech, given examples. So when you all do the evaluation, if you think of something, please write the example, why you think it's like that. Okay, now Shweta, I've got a minute for you. Good evening. Yes, you said good evening. That's good. Address the speaker or the moderator. Good evening, moderator, contest chair, fellow Toastmasters. And dear guests, and my target speaker, so and so. Ma'am used to give chocolates. That was a very good opening statement. Well, well done, well said. It attracted the audience. And you also spoke about one friend and two grandfathers and all your real life experiences. Very good. In short, you told us what you liked. That was good. Your gestures was good, especially the line when you said, I was lying down in bed and wondering what to do. So you had good confidence, a good smile, and you told us a good personal story. Okay, you opened like this, and now you're saying, let me tell you about how I'm going to analyze the speech. Then what was this? Don't go to analysis. You lost time there. Okay, give me a minute to finish, okay, Vamsi? 1 minute more. He has said you can take a minute. So then you talked about structure, opening, body is missing, conclusion is missing, eye contact, content and story was amazing. Work on the voice and the body. Like very sketchy recommendations you gave. You didn't give examples. And the summary, structure was good, energy, and thoroughly enjoyed. Only the challenge was in your voice modulation. Now, very sketchy. You didn't give examples and you were all over the place. So I want you to first analyze the speech in opening, body and conclusion and with examples. Then give recommendations of what you didn't like. I didn't like the way you referred to grandfather or something, whatever you didn't like. You could have done it this way. When you don't like something or when you want to improve something, please give an alternate. Okay, you can't send the speaker away, say, go away, please. I don't like the way you said this. Are? Then how do I say it? Acha, come back. Instead of narrating, you could have used dialogue like, oh, grandpa, let's go to Jew Beach. Ah, yes, certainly we will. Okay, instead of telling the story. So give examples. So opening with all the analysis, 40 marks of good points. There has to be more good points than bad, okay? Finish up all your good points. Then give recommendations. And then in summary, say what you have already said in good recommendations and one line which will send him away happily, her away, happily smiling. Say, I loved your speech and I enjoyed the 5 to 7 minutes that I spent and I thought it was well worth it. Okay. Got it? Okay, thank you very much. And if you have any questions, time permitting, you may ask. Over to you, moderator. Anubhuti, thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Now the room is open for a quick Q&A session. If any participants have any query, they can raise their hands. Yes, Shweta, go ahead.
I want to ask that if we are giving an evaluation, we have to give the structure of the, like how we are evaluating. Like there are so many structures like sandwich, and then DSC, ES methods. So we have to tell the audience. It confused me a little.
See, if you want to win, I just showed you the ballot form. If you want to win, no, go according to the analysis, analytical quality. Analyze the whole speech first. When they say analyze, that is the only scope to give the good points. Okay, so here it will be CRC, that sandwich method is CRC. Here it will be CRS, S is summary. And then one small line of C. So CRS and C. So C is commendation, R is recommendation, S is summary. If you want the 15 marks, if you want to be evaluated out of 85 marks, then do what you like, CRC or whatever. Because if you don't summarize, you will not get 15 marks. That's all. Don't get lost in methodology. Just do this. Got it? Just practice this for the next week now. Whenever you're doing it with someone, practice this. Comment, recommend, summarize, and one line to comment again, which is a general line. Say that, I loved your speech. That's all. A personal. Yes, Ria.
Ma'am, I have one question. It is said that your evaluation should be in a very positive note. If there is something which it happens that if we talk about that the speaker used some words which is not appropriate with the audience, or we felt that the the context or the content used by the speaker was not appropriate as per the audience, and you want to point that out. So how should we point that out? Because we felt that was not appropriate, or if we should, then how we should point it out?
Okay. First of all, you are not a representative of the audience. Please remember that. You are not speaking on behalf of the audience. You are speaking because you are an evaluator. You don't care whether the audience loved it, they hated it, or they laughed, or they cried. You are not their spokesperson, number one. Number two, you didn't like it. Tell her that it didn't go down too well with me, the usage of the word whatever, or damn, because damn, hell, these are swear words. And in Toastmasters, I feel at least we should be pristine in our language. We should be pure in the English language and not use swear words like damn or hell. Oh gosh, would have been a better substitute. Simple. And this is because you're feeling, not because audience like Anubhuti, Aditi, Dipalika and Aarti are feeling. No, it is you. Please remember that you are not a representative of the audience. It is a personal evaluation. So Riya, you can substitute that word for another and tell her that I would rather hear you say, oh gosh, instead of damn. Okay? Or whatever.
Yes, ma'am. Thank you.
Thank you. Okay, yes. Argun.
First of all, thank you very much, ma'am, for enlightening us with a lot of evaluation on our evaluations. It was wonderful listening to you. I was actually laughing half the time because, you know, it is my characteristic to laugh on myself when I do some mistakes. Okay. The one question that I have, which is enthralling me since the start, is how do you take faster notes? Because the speech is obviously going to be around 4 to 5 times faster than you write. So sometimes that makes a very big difference because you lose that one point which might change the entire evaluation to one of the best. So what would be your strategy, or what do you do in that?
I know, you're quite right. I also lose time, and I, like an idiot, I transcribe the whole speech. As she was speaking, I was writing, you know. As she was speaking, I was writing. But then I've realized now that I should just listen to her speech and write down on the left-hand side all the good points and the examples. Like a divide a page into two, on the left hand column I'll write good points and examples, on the right hand side not so good, NSG I write not so good and examples. So then I, in the 5 minutes that while she's talking, okay, and in the 5 minutes that I have, then I look at the left hand side, I look at the right hand side, and I say, okay, now out of this, which one should I take? Oh, this is good, this is good, this is 3 or 4 I take. And on the not so good, if I've written 20, I obviously can't say all 20. So I have to say only 2 or 3. So then I take the 2 real relevant ones, like content of the speech or effect on me of your speech or call for action or do you own your opinion or are you generalizing? Are you going into the depth of the speech or it's just gratitude, gratitude? Okay. So find something that others cannot find. Go deep inside the speech and find something as a recommendation that others will not give. Others will give light, others will give modulation, others will give standing, sitting. Don't go there. Go something in the speech which affected you. Like I felt that she applied closure to her act of gratitude or no act of gratitude by meeting Aditi again, which I felt was a great thing. That loop was closed. So I would have mentioned the good point. I also felt that too much was said about the grandparent or reference, a very glib reference was made to the parents who were suffering from cancer, or one other grandfather who had died early. It was not necessary. It made us feel sad. And then that sadness was not recovered at all. We were still feeling sad for it. So I would have pointed that as a recommendation. So go into the speech and pull out something that only you have found. Get involved in the speech and pull out something. And point it out. I'm sure the judges will say, "Are ha! This was not mentioned by anyone else. Chalo, let me give him marks for that." Follow. Substantiate it with the example and say it.
Thank That's you, what I just another small question, because it's an online platform, and whenever we give evaluations or speeches with respect to an online platform, it's Word document or Microsoft Word or any document editor which we use. How would you help us or suggest us to maintain eye contact, because there's a piece of paper you'll have to look towards is and the webcam. So a small recommendation over there for us.
So the judges do not mark you down for losing eye contact, because even in an evaluation contest offline, that is physical, we are allowed to take our notes. We are allowed to take our notes. So I stand with my, when I'm giving my evaluation, I do this. Okay, Shweta said, ma'am, you used to give us chocolate. So like that. Then I refer friend and then. So you can go back and forth, back and forth. You're allowed. But don't do it in a haphazard manner. Don't let all your papers fly all over and then they say, "Arey, it fell down." Keep it ready. And some people, you know, go without a paper also, which is great, but it does not mark you down. As long as succinctly you give analysis, recommendation, and summary. That is commendation, recommendation, summary. The judges also, you have to put your hand in the judge's pocket and take out those marks. How will you do that? By giving what is in the form. What is in the form? Analytical, 40 marks. Analyze a speech, take 40 marks. Recommend, 30, take 30. How you'll recommend nicely, sweetly, so sweet. Beta, I love you. Darling, I'm in love with you. You have given such a wonderful speech, Sakshi, that I cannot forget the way you spoke. Okay? Judges are saying, really, yaar, this girl, lovely, very good. Chalo. Technique, tamma. And summary, as I told you, Sakshi, that you have given a wonderful speech. The gratitude is a seldom used word, and you have brought out the nuances of the word. But if you had said narration instead of this and this and this, but in the end, I must tell you, I was blown off my seat, because you gave us a personal example, and I'm taking that home with me. Thank you. Contest. But don't overdo that last line, okay? That last line has to be only one line. Okay. Yes.
Thank you, ma'am, for such a... sorry, Gaurav, for the benefit of time, we need to skip your question, but you can...
Send it.
You can type it in the chat box. Thank you. Thank you, ma'am, for such a valuable feedback and such detailed answer. Now, I would like to request Division N Director Toastmaster Dipalika to facilitate our role players for day one.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Anubhuti. Can you please share the screen? Can we go ahead with this? Thank you. Distinguished Toastmaster Veena, it was a pleasure to have you with us. We have learned so much. I still remember my first evaluation contest where I forgot the name of the test speaker. And I just mentioned that person as the test speaker itself and just survived those 3 minutes. Now that we have all the tips and tricks, even if we are not participating in the contest, this will surely help us with the evaluations in our club meetings. Thank you so much for being the trainer, and thank you so much for being the super evaluator today. The next one, please. We have Toastmaster Anjali as the Chief Sergeant at Arms. Thank you, Toastmaster Anjali, for opening the meeting on time and laying the ground rules. We have Toastmaster Radhika as the Sergeant at Arms. Thank you so much, Toastmaster Radhika, for being there in the breakout room. I hope you had your share of learnings as well in the whole marathon. We have Toastmaster Ramsey as the timer one. Thank you for letting us know the timings and pinpointing us. Any questions that we have, we can take it in the chat box right now. Because of the paucity of time, we have to move forward. Our next timer was Toastmaster Bhavini. Thank you so much, Toastmaster Bhavini, for letting us know the timings. We have Toastmaster Anubhuti as our moderator, fantastically transitioning between everything and letting us know what happens next. Thank you so much, Toastmaster Anubhuti. We have Toastmaster Yash, our super quick Zoom master. As soon as Distinguished Toastmaster Veena asked for the evaluation sheet, he presented the screen, and that is what we require. Thank you so much for being behind the screens, but still helping with the continuous flow of the whole marathon. I now thank all the participants, the evaluators, the test speaker, Toastmaster Sakshi, and everybody who could attend today's evaluation marathon. We have similar marathons for the next 4 days. Please do join us. There will be so many tips and tricks, so many learnings to crack your marathons, to crack your evaluation contest, as well as to learn from the experts that we have in our district. Thank you so much. Over to you, Toastmaster Anubhuti.
Thank you, Toastmaster Dipalika. It was a wonderful day one, full of learnings, and tomorrow we'll be back with the day two of Division N Evaluation Marathon with a new set of participants, role players, and one more seasoned Toastmaster as our super evaluator. Now, I hand over the stage to Sergeant at Arms to officially close the meeting. Over to you, Toastmaster Anjali.
I hope you all enjoyed today's session and had a great learning time. Let's meet us all tomorrow at the same time. And now I declare the meeting closed. Thank you everyone for joining.